LLC is the new Werner Herzog film, and this time it's a Japanese docufiction. Werner Herzog is easily one of my favorite directors of all time. I've recently been reading his book, A Guide for the Perplexed, which is so far one of the best interviews with a director I've ever read, so I highly recommend it if you like Herzog. But his filmography is long, he's been working since the 60s, he's made countless masterpieces, countless wonderful documentaries, impressive pieces of fiction, and I don't remember who said it exactly, but reading up on him, someone said that with his fiction films, Herzog almost tries to find some sort of documentary feeling to them. Well, for his documentaries, he tries to make them more cinematic. And this perfectly applies to Family Romance LLC, which is at the same time a fiction film and a documentary. It is about this company, actual company, which is owned by the actual protagonist of the film, Yumi Nishi, the Family Romance LLC. It's a company in Japan, in Tokyo, that people can use to rent family members, to rent friends, to rent anyone they want. And I'm not gonna make examples because that's one of the best things about the film, just discovering, finding out who's real, who's not. But it's a fascinating concept. It's a fascinating actual company. And it's very emblematic of the times we're living in. And this is definitely one of the themes of the film for Herzog. Not so as well as talking about identity, like those people, they start to lose idea of who they really are, of what's real and what's not. It becomes very easy for them to lose touch with reality, to get too involved in those other people's lives just to help them out. But the concept that we're just becoming lonelier and lonelier with computers, with the internet, with a lot of other things that are going on in the world, we are becoming more lonely people. We have less human interactions, and such things become an actual commodity pretty much. If you want to have someone to talk to, someone that can be there in a moment of need, in a memorable occasion or an event or whatever, you can just buy someone to pretend to be part of your life. And that's just very sad. It's very, very sad. But at the same time, it's something helpful. It's something good, something that people do need. And that's what's present in this film. I honestly loved watching this, but I can easily see it being very divisive, and it's not been getting very high scores generally. One of the main reasons, this was shot pretty much guerrilla style in Tokyo. It's just Herzog being his own cinematographer and cameraman, filming those actors in crowded Tokyo streets, in the subway, and it's all handheld, it's all... Saying and calling it amateurish feels like a detriment to the film. I liked how back to basics he went. Purposely so, even talked about it in the Q&A afterwards in the presentation on the movie. He purposely made it like this. He purposely wanted to go back to the roots of his first films that had like just a couple people working on those films. A masterpiece like Land of Silence and Darkness. That was shot with only two people, Herzog and the cameraman or the sound operator or whatever. It's just that simple. And the same applies to Family Romance LLC. Herzog is showing, pretty much in almost an experimental way, he's showing that you don't need the best cameras, you don't need 1,000 lights, you don't need a 100 people crew to make a compelling and interesting film. Sometimes you just need a good idea, you need good actors, and that's it. And that's what he did. And all the characters, played mostly by people who actually belong to the Family Romance LLC company, most of these characters, they are very fascinating. They are generally pretty good actors. Yumi Nishi, especially the protagonist, he gave a really solid performance. I was very surprised by that. There is a girl, another main character in the film, Mahiro, I think, that's not pretty very good at the beginning. It works with her character, but you can tell she's struggling like not to look into the camera. But the longer the film goes on, the more accustomed you should get to the filmmaking process, and she delivers a solid performance by the end. And again, this is a fiction film, but it's shot almost like a documentary. There are parts that are legit documentaries, just a couple interviews with real people. There is a famous Japanese oracle. that he's visited some actual locations that have very weird things, like a robot hotel. So the film is experimental, borderline experimental. It's very peculiar, and the thing I loved about it is 100% a Werner Herzog film. If you're a fan of his work, if you like his look at philosophical looks at the nature of identity, of humanity, what we're going through, what we're gonna end up doing, maybe robots will take over these family romance people, who knows? It's kind of disturbing. There is a sense of hope, but also of loneliness and melancholy that permeates the entire film. And I would say it's probably the best film Herzog has made, best proper fiction film since Bad Lieutenant, easily. So I highly, highly recommend you watch Family Romance LLC. If you're not a Herzog fan, I'd be curious to hear what you think. Just be prepared for a simpler look, simpler style, this docu-fiction narrative, but yeah, slowly paced, meandering, but with a purpose, with a relaxing feeling to it. I loved it. I really loved it. But still, guys, have you watched Family Romance LLC, and which is your favorite Werner Herzog film? Tell me in the comments below. Thanks for watching, to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.